Today, breaking news. HIFU melted my face. Da, da, da. Ah! But did it actually? Or did it give you more fat? Ooh. That is one of the things that I'm going to be talking about today. How you can use HIFU to regrow the fat in your face. Mind blowing. If you Google HIFU, you will see tons and tons and tons of reports of how a patient has had a HIFU device and they found that their face looks saggier afterwards. And it's often said that the patient looks worse afterwards because it's melted their fat, they feel more hollow, and they just don't like the results. One reason for this can just be because, you know, you're getting older anyway, you are going to experience fat loss anyway, so it's possible that those two things have coincided, particularly if you are undergoing some hormonal changes at that point. The thing is, you can actually use HIFU to remove fat. That is one of the uses of the device. So it kind of makes sense that if it's being used inappropriately, that you could in theory get rid of the fat that you don't want to lose. Let's just do a brief recap on HIFU. So HIFU uses ultrasound, which is targeted at a specific layer underneath the skin. So very commonly, the depths that you will be treating will be 4.5 millimeters, 3 millimeters, 2 millimeters and 1.5 millimeters. You can get deeper body cartridges, which often will go up to 13 millimeters. But for the face, this is what we're talking about. Interestingly, on the vast majority of devices, there's no way to tell precisely where you are treating because it's only the Ulthera which has the deep sea mechanism. This allows you to be able to see using an ultrasound device the depth at which the energy is penetrating to. Is that important? I would probably say it's not as important as you think it might be. And I am talking about clinical results there. So I use the ULTRAcel Q Plus, which is a Korean device, and I have also used the Ulthera as well. For various reasons, the Ulthera is much more painful than the ULTRAcel Q+, and the treatment time is much longer. However, the manufacturers recommend that you only do one treatment per year, roughly, with the Ulthera, whereas with the ULTRAcel Q+, you can do one every 3 months if you wanted to. But what that really equates to is you're doing 3 treatments over the course of the year, if you're doing it for skin tightening. If you're doing it for fat loss, or also if you're doing it for fat growth, you need to do more treatment sessions, which are priced accordingly. HIFU is quite unique in that you're not having to cause damage to the more superficial layers of the skin to get deeper, because the energy bypasses the more superficial layers because you're doing it in like a cone beam effect. So if you imagine when you put the probe on the skin, the energy is being emitted all the way down the handpiece, but it's been focused at one point underneath the skin. Well, a few points underneath the skin, but like this. Previously, all HIFU devices were firing a line of dots underneath the skin, but the more modern devices actually fire a line of ultrasound. So you're treating a bigger surface area every time you apply the handpiece. ULTRAcel do have a new device out last year, ULTRAcel Zí, which is not available here yet. And I am absolutely, I mean, to say that I'm desperate to try it is a huge understatement. The principle is that you can switch between the dot and the linear setting without having to change the cartridge, which will significantly decrease the treatment time. I would imagine that the outcome would be the same, however, unless you're using the new protocols. It's quite reductive to just compare the depth at which the treatment is taking place with ultrasound, because a lot of the result also depends on the frequency of the device, which are different. Even in the same device range, you will have a different frequency depending on the cartridge. So for example, with the ULTRAcel Q Plus, some of the cartridges, although they're the same depth, they'll have a different frequency than the Z. So even if you set them up with the same power output and depth, the energy travels deeper the longer the wavelength is. Frequency is the inverse of wavelength. So the longer the frequency is, the wider surface area the energy will spread over. So if you're doing, say, a 3mm cartridge, if you're using a 4MHz device, it will spread it over a wider area than a 7MHz device. One of the things that can possibly be a risk when you're doing HIFU treatments is overlapping the focal points. So you can imagine if you're using a 2mm cartridge and a 1mm cartridge, it's possible that the focal points could possibly overlap because you've only got a leeway of 0.5mm. And, you know, we're talking about a 3D point here. So, you know, they could potentially do this, which will cause a burn. Practically, what is the difference then between the dot and the linear cartridges? The dot is said to be for lifting and tightening. What you're trying to do with the dot is elevate pinpoints of the skin tissue temperature to be 65 degrees or above. This is because this is the temperature at which collagen denaturation occurs. So the idea is that you'll have these focal points where you've got coagulated tissue and that's surrounded by normal tissue which has not been harmed. So in addition to this local coagulation, the heat application causes collagen fibers in the subcutaneous fat layer to become denatured and contract. Also, you get new collagen formation occurring within the areas of the tissue coagulation, and this results in a lifting and tightening of the lax skin. So the linear cartridges are designed more for contouring the face, and they are supposed to reach a temperature of 58 degrees or above. And it's at this temperature that you start to get fat loss. Makes sense, right? This is why I only recommend that patients who have got a fuller face, like myself, do HIFU. Not people who come in with a skinny face and not much fat, unless they are doing the fat growth protocol, which I'm going to come to later. Okay, so historically, it's been said that you use linear for contouring the face and reduction of fat, but some more recent studies have shown that the dot cartridges actually cause more fat loss. So check this out. So in this rat study, they received treatment at 3mm and an energy of 0.6 joules. And the results showed that the fat thickness gradually decreased even in cases where the HIFU did not cause cellular necrosis. They also showed that the heat from the HIFU triggers the production of P53 in mitochondria, which induces apoptosis and autophagy. So if you just blindly use HIFU all across the whole face, and even at temperatures which are not supposed to give you fat loss, you're still going to get fat loss. But as you get older, in any case, you actually put fat on in various areas, and you will get more fat in the eye bags, the nasolabial fold, the jowls, the marionette area. So why would you not use the HIFU there to shrink that fat down? And this is actually an increase in fat. This is not just the repositioning of fat that you previously had. Okay, so the next bit that I'm going to show you is really, it's very early days for this new concept of fat growth via HIFU. And there are a very, very limited number of studies published, because that's how science works. You have to start somewhere and then you keep building on that. So don't come at me in the comments saying, oh, you know, where's all the evidence? This is all there is, okay? There's no more evidence. It's early days. Don't get me started on evidence-based medicine and whether or not that's a real thing. So there's a paper in 2022 that reported that HIFU irradiation could cause an increase in adipose tissue. So irradiating with HIFU upregulated HSP70S and reduced inflammatory cytokines. And it also governed the cilia of the adipose-derived stem cells, increased the number of adipocytes, and increased the thickness of the subcutaneous fat. So how does it do this? Well, it's going to decrease the amount of inflammatory cytokines that you have in the fat, which causes you to grow more fat in that area. And as I've mentioned, in certain areas, you are going to need more fat as you get older, like the temples, the forehead, the area above the eyelid, the area below the cheekbone. These all lose fat. And actually, there are some clinics in South Korea who are already using HIFU to get more fat. I first heard about this when I was at a conference in Japan last year, and it's something which has just come over there as well. Okay, so why is this relevant? If you've been watching this channel for a while, you will know that one of the things that makes us look older as we age is either the repositioning of fat or the atrophy of fat. Now, in the mid and lower face, generally speaking, the deep and superficial fat compartments are repositioned, but in the forehead, they atrophy. So you get less volume there as you get older. In general, it's believed that deep fat atrophies and superficial fat tends to reposition or hypertrophy. Fat atrophy has been commonly observed in the superficial fat compartments of the forehead and in the periorbital and perioral regions. If you can therefore use HIFU to remove fat from areas where you have fat hypertrophy and also gain fat where you've got not enough of it, and you can use it for skin tightening, it sounds like a pretty good treatment to me. Until super recently, the only way that you could gain more fat was the use of needles. But isn't it quite compelling that you can now do that without having any injections at all? Although, yes, admittedly, the gains are small. If you're going to do HIFU anyway, why not do it with proper contouring? Okay, so what I meant before about it not being that relevant, whether or not you have got the deep sea device like on the Ulthera, I mean, you can just check the fat depth with a handheld ultrasound device if you want to do that. It doesn't have to be something that is in real time, if you see what I mean. So a lot of clinics will just have a normal ultrasound device knocking around these days. So what are they actually doing in Korea? Well, they do check the depth of the fat first. They're doing one treatment every 1 to 2 weeks if they're doing it for fat growth. They're doing 50 shots for every 5 by 5 centimeter square area. 0.2 joules if you want to increase the fat, 0.6 if you want to decrease the fat. Which is interesting actually, because in the past, if we wanted to decrease the fat, we've always just cranked it up as much as possible. But actually, the more recent studies have shown that if you decrease the energy, you decrease the amount of inflammatory cytokines that you get, which gives you a better result. So when you're irradiating at 0.2 joules, your focal point is going to be about 40 degrees. And of course, it's less than the temperature at which you would get fat loss. Makes sense. And if you're doing it at 0.6 joules, it's about 54 degrees. Annoyingly, if you're just doing it for fat gain, you will start to see an improvement in the fat at around 5 treatments. Apparently, in Korea, they're doing around 10 treatments for an indication such as this. But obviously, you're not doing the whole face when you're doing it for fat gain. You might just be treating, say, the forehead and the periorbital area, which means that it's a much quicker and more cost-effective treatment. So we have a whole new protocol for using HIFU in the clinic, and this is pretty brand new stuff. So before, we would just crank it up as much as you possibly could in the hope that you're going to get more skin tightening. But now we're using it in a much more subtle, refined fashion, looking at where the patient will have lost fat, where they will have gained fat, and then treating them appropriately. So for example, you're going to use a 3 millimeter dot at 0.6 joules to try to decrease fat. You're going to use the same cartridge, so 3 millimeters at 0.2 joules to increase fat. Interestingly, you're going to see an increase in the elasticity if you use the 2 millimeter linear cartridge at 0.5 joules. This is brand new stuff. I don't think that there are other clinics outside maybe Korea and more recently Japan doing this type of really personalized work. We have literally only just started doing it because I saw it at the conference in Japan. So apart from the fat loss, which distresses a lot of people, or the concept of it distresses a lot of people, what are the real issues that you can see with HIFU? What's the most common thing? Well, first of all, pain. It can be uncomfortable in certain spots, although at the new energy settings that we're using for treatment, it's much more comfortable than it used to be, particularly with the ULTRAcel Q plus. The Ultherapy is still painful. You can get nerve damage causing facial paralysis or a numbness of the skin, although I personally have never seen it. Acute cataracts of the eye. In fact, there was a case of this quite recently in Japan. Basically, she was treated at a salon and they had treated over her eyelids using the device, burnt the eye. Fortunately, she was fine. They replaced her lens and all was good. Makes sense. The skin of the eyelid is only about 1.5 millimeters in thickness. So, of course, if you're using even a 1.5 millimeter thick cartridge, you may end up with problems. And that's the most shallow depth that there is. You can treat the skin of the upper eyelid here. However, I would never treat directly over the eye itself. And it's recommended that you use eye shields. One of the risks with HIFU is burning the skin, so you can imagine a case in which that might happen if you're treating over a prominence, so a bony prominence, and it means that the cartridge is not connecting properly with the skin, so of course the depth is not going to be correct, so you're applying the heat at the wrong layer. Likewise, if you use too much gel, you're decreasing the depth at which the cartridge will focus because of the gel being between the cartridge and the skin. Okay, so I hope that all made a ton of sense, and you don't have to be scared of HIFU. You do have to be scared of who's doing it for you, is my summary. If you have any questions about HIFU, drop them in the comment section below. I'll see you later.